Greetings to you, my colleagues, pastors, assembly leaders, as well as our fellow AFM members. You are all aware that the president of the country has declared that the country should transition from alert level 3 to alert level 2. We are grateful that some of the regulations have been somewhat eased. We can be able now to do more, although it is with a tinge of disappointment that the church gatherings are still restricted to 50. We are, however, hopeful that we will be able to gather in bigger numbers as we move from this level to the next level. I'm a bit encouraged by the fact that of those that become infected, quite a huge percentage is recovering. Of course, our hearts go to all the families of those that have succumbed to the pandemic. May the Lord give them strength as they are going through their bereavement. I would just like to encourage you today. Let me just read one scripture that we find in Ephesians chapter 6, verse number 10. In the NIV, it reads, "Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power." Yes, the Apostle Paul was addressing the church of Ephesus. He was clear in his mind that they were in a war zone. He was urging them to be fully armed. But even with all the armaments that they would have, he is urging them to be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. It is comforting that our Lord gives us the strength and our Lord is powerful. I know it has not been easy for us during these months of lockdown. It has not been easy for me as well. We have lost quite a number of our pastors and pastors' spouses. And some of them, it was COVID-related. We are sending our condolences to all of their families and their local congregations. May the Lord also make their families and their congregations to be strong in the Lord, knowing that the Lord is able to pull them through. Now, we are still experiencing the impact that is not so good in many areas of our ministry. I have already indicated that as far as our gatherings are concerned, we are still limited to 50. Weddings can take place, but they are also limited to number 50. Obviously, the other areas where we are feeling the heat is around the finances. Many of our congregations are not able to receive offerings and tithes because of the current situation in which we find ourselves. But I would like to urge all of our members that can be able to deposit money into their local congregations to do so, so that we are able to do everything that we need to do. So please take care of your pastors in whatever way, especially our congregations that are in deep rural, that are in small areas. Please remember the servants of the Lord during this time. But I'm also saying we must also take hands with our members. A number of them have lost jobs, and quite a sizable number also have had their businesses grounded. We are going into quite a rough patch, but even as we are going through, the Lord is saying we need to remain strong in Him and in His power. The Lord will take us through the storm. The Lord is not going to abandon us at a time like this. It is when it is dark that the Lord shows forth His power. He will be with us. He will take us through. And I want to encourage you to be strong, knowing that your future and my future is in the hands of the Lord. And the Lord knows exactly where He is taking us. We may not be able during this year maybe to do our regional elections, our national elections, but certainly we will be able to do this at an appropriate time. So I'm encouraging you, don't allow the current situation to overwhelm you. Don't allow uncertainties about the future to make you lose perspective. Keep focus, keep the perspective, because the Lord is with us. We will pull through. And as we are pulling through, we will have a very good reason to say to you, Lord, be the glory, the honor, and the power forever and ever. God bless you. I love you.